real nigga, and I'm looking for me a fire girl. Hold down the spot when a nigga hit the block and the help take over this entire world. Fire.
Illegitimate started as a basic desire, man. It started as a desire to kind of have my own thing going, almost like an independent label situation, and just to really shed some light on me and my crew collectively, to kind of want to maybe increase my chance of the possibility of a major label, you know what I'm saying, coming and connecting with us or coming searching for me and my crew collectively or whatever. So that's where pretty much where the idea, or you know what I'm saying, the thought of me pretty much kind of creating this sub label, I guess, or you know, it's our own independent label. And the name came about, you know, I just wanted to I wanted something that kind of represented the positive as well as the negative truth, you know what I mean? So I kind of merged two words, which kind of created one word, and you know, illegitimate. And I just do recordings on the end because it's all about the material, man. It's all about the work that we put in, put out. Musical influences, jeez, this is gonna be, musical influences, man. Well, some of my very first rap artists that I was listening to. Well, of course, Bone Thugs and Harmony, and man, I had a real heavy Pac phase, a phase I was on Pac heavy, man, right in middle school or whatever. And prior to that, after that, when I really dove into rap and really got to understand hip hop for more of what it was, man, Jay was the first artist. Jay Z was the very first artist where I started to really recognize like lyricism at a different degree. And so, man, I took a lot of aspects from Jay, man. And as far as like street appeal, man, and more of an edgier sound, man. Like I was on a lot of the guys from the South heavy, man. Like Boosie and Jeezy, man. And but I'm gonna say for where I am now, man. You know, I took a lot from Jay, man. I took a lot from Jay, and Jay, and maybe a little bit of the edgier side from Pac, man. And my social awareness, a little social awareness from a little Lupe, and you know, that's pretty much it, man. What sets me apart, man, from other artists, I feel like I have, there's something about me, man. My music is 100% natural, man, and it's real, you know what I mean? I'm gonna say what I feel when I feel it, you know what I mean? And I'm gonna try to always capture every element of myself, you know what I mean? There's not a topic or something that I wouldn't discuss in my music, you know what I'm saying? So I feel like that's definitely one thing that sets me apart, man. I try to be real as possible 100% of the time, you know what I mean? So what you can expect is to still be on the lookout for the Rough Draft, still go cop the Rough Draft, still me promoting the Rough Draft, still me promoting the single, the C100 and Chase of Dreams, if you haven't had a chance to go check that out, man. Still be on the lookout for up and coming projects, man. Make sure you go check out the Gateway Cypher 3 that I just shot with T-More Media. Check him out, follow him on Twitter, man, T-More Media. Just keep your eyes open for any projects, man, that I I got a project coming with Sonny Raw at 314. Make sure you go check out his Hipstamental page at Hipstamental's Sonny Raw 314. And be on the lookout for my new project I got in the making. I think I'm gonna title it Substance Abuse. I'm not releasing any tracks yet for that project, but keep your eyes and your ears open, man, because it's definitely coming. And that's pretty much it, man. Man, I just want to shout out pretty much everybody I run with, man, in my inner circle, my intermediate circle or whatever, man. Make sure y'all look out for my boy Nehemiah, man. Check out for my boy, Sonny, like I said, Sonny Raw, 314, man, one of the illest producers out of the Midwest. Not because it's my dude, because he's the most talented guy I know with the production, man. And make sure y'all check out follow my dude, Nick, man. Hey, yo, Nick, be on the lookout for more stuff from Limitless TV, man. Keep your eyes and ears open for any illegitimate projects, man, any illegitimate recording projects, man. Check out my dude, Ron G. Montana. Follow him, man, at Ron G. Montana, man. That's my guy. Let me see what else we got going. Make sure, the Gateway Cypher 3, man. Go and support, man, and make sure y'all go holler at T-More Media for anything you need, man. That's pretty much it, man. When two was played, I got got it.